Hi, I'm Franco Rotoli from the Solidworks training team. In this bonus video, I'll be modeling the final two components of the assembly, the cog and the pin. These two components were shown in the video named Foam Holder, Holder Assembly in this playlist. Click the links below to watch that video or to access the entire playlist. Let's jump into xDesign and start modeling. I started a new part named cog, and I'll start a sketch on the YZ plane. I'll sketch a circle centered on the origin and give it a diameter of 60 millimeters. Good design practice is to keep solid extrudes and cuts in separate features, so I won't add any other geometry here. I'll just extrude this 5 millimeters solid. I'll hide the planes to clean things up a little and start a sketch on the front face of the disc. I'll sketch a small circle for the hole where the pin will fit. 4 millimeters is a little bigger than the pin diameter, so it can spin. I'll use the cut extrude command to remove material and make the end condition through one way to ensure if the thickness changes, I won't have to worry about the hole not cutting all the way through. Next, I'll start another sketch on the face of the disc and drop a point about here. This step isn't 100% necessary. I could have sketched the center arc slot in an arbitrary position and dimensioned the center point later, but in this case, it's nice to have a defined starting point. Picking the center arc slot tool, remember, the tool shows me with white squares where I have to click to sketch this. So I'll click the center point first, then the two ends of the slot, and finally, the width of the slot. I'll dimension the slot based on the drawing. Now I'll cut extrude this sketch with a through one-way end condition as well. The last feature for the cog is a circular pattern of the slot. Per the note, it's 180 degrees from the one I just created. On the Features toolbar, I'll click the corner of the Linear Pattern tool and choose Circular Pattern. I'll choose Cut Extrude 3 from the Design Manager as the feature to pattern, and the outside circular edge for the pattern axis. I could have also chosen the edge of the hole since they're concentric. I'll change the angle to 180 degrees and the number of instances to 2. That completes the cog part. I'll save it to the platform for later. Next is the pin component. This time, I'll start a sketch on the XY plane. The first thing I sketch when creating a revolved part, like this pin, is a center line. While this construction tool is activated, any sketch entities that I make will be construction, or center lines. So I'll simply sketch a horizontal line starting at the origin. When making a revolved feature, it's best practice to keep all your sketch entities on one side of the revolve axis. This construction line will help me with that visually, as well as helping with dimensions. I'll turn the construction tool off so I can sketch solid lines now. I'll draw the profile of the pin, remembering to mind my cursor feedback and taking advantage of the tangent arc shortcut. Remember, if you're sketching a chain of lines, you can move the cursor back over the last point you made, and depending on the direction you come off of that point, it will change to an arc. Now I'll finish closing off the sketch. But I see that all the lines are still blue. I would expect some black lines based on automatic sketch relations. I'll hit Escape on my keyboard to drop the line tool and drag some blue lines so we see why I still have degrees of freedom in this sketch. It looks like this line isn't coincident to the origin. I'll control select the line and the origin and add a coincident relation between them. That's starting to look better. I'll add the rest of the dimensions based on the drawing. Another advantage of having a construction line in a sketch is that when we dimension to it and drop the dimension on the opposite side, it will drop a doubled dimension. This will give us the diameter value. I'll give it a length. And lastly, I'll revolve the sketch 360 degrees to make the solid. This completes the pin component. Once I save this part to the platform, I'll have access to it in my assembly. Thanks for watching. Again, click the link below to access the other videos in this playlist, Beginner's Guide to xDesign. And as always, happy modeling.